Hey y'all, so it's been a hot minute since I sat down, recorded, and uploaded and everything, but hey, welcome back to my channel. It's been a little minute. The last video y'all seen was, I think it was my birthday video. I'm 24. It's now April. It's April 20th. Happy 420. If y'all remember the 420 videos I made, if not, they're gonna be linked right here so you guys can go check them out. I am not a smoker anymore. I have not indulged in so long. I will not be smoking today, but we will be having some munchies, okay? You guys have no idea. I would love to smoke a big flat blunt with the week, the month, the beginning of the year, all of last year, all of these things combined, everything I've been going through. I would love to smoke a big fat juicy one all the way down to the filter and just be on my merry way, but I'm not going to. I'm gonna just relax. Today we have a little fun day going on. Well, not really fun, but I'm gonna do a mukbang for you guys. I just ordered some Taco Bell. I ordered a lot, but I won't be eating a lot. I probably will only eat like maybe one or two things that I got. The rest will be like for lunch or dinner. I'm just gonna give to the rest of my family, but I will not be eating everything that I got. But I bought a lot, but you guys only see me eat maybe one thing. I'm not trying to make this be a long video. We're just gonna be talking about what's been going on, catching you guys up, trying to see what's going on. We gotta get to the deal. It's morning time, so we're gonna wash my face and like brush my teeth. This is my first time eating today. I'm still gonna brush my teeth. Like, I feel like I shouldn't because I'm about to eat Taco Bell of all things. So I'm gonna brush my teeth and then brush my teeth after. So let's do that. I feel like I don't know what I'm doing, I feel like it's so foreign to me. It's been so long. Of course the cat has to make an entrance and do a journey in here with me. I've been starting to use Dove bar soap on my face. I'm trying to see if that works. It's the Dove Sensitive Beauty Bar. I usually use this, but I've been seeing a lot of acne, so I'm gonna be trying to use this. Maybe I'll do like one in the morning, one at night. We'll see what's going on. But I used this for the first time last night. I cut it up, and when I tried to cut it, it ended up in several pieces. So I'm starting with the small piece first. This is what I also use to wash my kitty cat, because I'm obviously, it's sensitive. It's a sensitive area. It's fragrance free, all that stuff. I use that when I wash down there. Other than that, the rest of my body, I just use body wash. So obviously, first, I'm gonna use warm water to wash my hands and then brush my teeth. Hello, Simba. I'm gonna use little baby lather up. Look at, first I'm gonna get my face wet. Yesterday I just got this wet and just rubbed it all over my face. But and I have very sensitive skin. I'm gonna leave this on for about 2-3 minutes. Don't get a cat. If you don't have a cat already, don't get one. Don't do it to yourself. So, how are you guys doing? It's been so long, like I said already. And man, have these months just been some months, been some months, been some months, been some months. Like, I be really contemplating and thinking about starting a podcast. Because not everything needs to be on camera, not everything needs to be said. But sometimes there's topics that I want to talk about. I want to have a co-host. It would be Becky, of course. And I want to be able to talk about some topics that I don't necessarily want to talk about on camera or like post as a YouTube video. I want to have a podcast, have these certain panels and talk about these certain situations and these certain things, because there's so much going on, not just with me but within the world. I feel like it needs to be talked about. There's so many certain topics that I like to be talking to myself about, like having my own little interview about, because it needs to be said. And sometimes I like, after I say these things, I'd be like, oh damn, like I wish I recorded myself. Why didn't I record? Because it's such good topics and I'm happy having such a good conversation with myself, and it's like, damn, like that would have been a good point to say. That would have been a good point to talk about. That would be a good point to remember. Don't remember it. I'm gonna go back in. As you can see, when I went on with the soap by itself, like when I went in with the soap like this, it lasted longer on my face. All right, we're done. I've been wanting to talk about certain things, and I'm just like, oh, I just need to start recording myself, because I be saying some stuff, and I just be like, yo. Yo, that's true. That's right. Uh-huh. Oh, that makes sense. For sure. For sure. I'm just gonna keep saying the same thing over again. There's so much to talk about that I want to be said. I just don't want it to be within my YouTube. I feel like it's topics that need to be talked about with other people. So I've been thinking.
So, per usual, my hammer died. But the food is here. Got some sauces. Okay, I got mild and hot. I also got some extra sour cream. I got some guacamole. There's something missing. I asked for that avocado ranch. And there's no avocado ranch. One avocado ranch, one sour cream, and one guacamole. It might be in here, but I don't know what I'm going to eat first. But I'll just pull out the first thing that's right here. Oh, this is the, like, I don't know. It's like the taco with the soft shell and the hard shell. Some crunch. Crunch, 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 crunch. So I made my first TikTok purchase, okay? I bought these. I'm going to check them out. It's the Euro Vaginal Probiotic. We're going to see what it do. This is only my second day using it. We're going to see what's to it. I'm using it for the vaginal health part, but you know, everybody and their mama got something to say about it, including the men, which is kind of insane to me how men could say something about a female probiotic, because the men on TikTok got a lot to say about it. It hits. Be right back. Let me get some water. I'm back. Water be hitting. And you know, it pleases me to see my pee come out very light yellow or clear. But I know when it's clear, that means I'm too hydrated. But yeah, I'm just like, men be saying a lot about this probiotic. It's like, if you want to be swimming in your girl, you want to be eating her up for hours, if you want them knees to be weak, get your little baby on these. But I was like, you know what, let me try it. It was like $20-something, but because I never purchased anything off of TikTok before, I got like a little discount thing. And I tell you, this was $7 and some change. First of all, don't be like, oh, this bitch got scammed. No, I got this. First of all, before even purchasing, I made sure it was from the actual people, O Positive, with their little blue check mark. I was them. They didn't get me. They did not get me. I'm kind of sad. Because not the avocado thing was like $1. I really wanted to try it. I was really looking forward to it. But what else is new? You know, besides starting these new pills and stuff like that. I just started. January 31st, I started new birth control. I started the Nexplanon. That's the one in the arm. She's right here. Hey. Be right there. I have had like third time's a charm when it comes to birth control. I've had the IUD twice, and I was gonna do like a third time, but third time's a charm, but I was like, fuck that, no. I kept having the problem of strings were poking my vagina wall and like the outside. Like, I could just feel it poking me. That's not great. It's an uncomfortable feeling, okay? Like, it's already a foreign thing being in your body, but it's another thing when that foreign thing is making itself known. If it's making itself known, it's becoming uncomfortable. And the fact that I could sit on the toilet, literally put my hand, like when I was checking and everything, I could literally put my hand back there, don't even have to put my finger inside my vagina, and I could feel the strings. The strings should not be coming out of my vagina hole. It should not be. I was like, no. And so we tried again with a different one, and it was like the same thing. And I was like, fuck this shit. I don't want it. And like, I was on my period for a long time. I felt clots. It's like the clots. I sometimes on my period can have major clots. The clots were getting stuck on the IUD. It wasn't coming out. Not a great feeling. It's not a great feeling. So I was like, fuck it, take it out. And when I think I talked to you guys about this, about one of the videos when I went to the doctor, they took it out and there was a whole bunch of clot that were coming out of it. Then I tried the pills, and on the pills, like, it didn't feel great. Like, I was bleeding a lot and just I wasn't feeling great. So I was like, no, I don't want it. So I went without birth control for a while. And the birth control is not for me being sexually active. No, it's to help regulate my periods, because I could go months and not have a period, or I can go months and my period lasts a month, and it's like, it's not fun. I'm already at 27 days of being on my period now because my body's trying to get used to the birth control. And now I've had this for like
like a month and a half. I had one period, and then I had a week, and my first period being on this birth control was 17 days, and I had a week and like 4 days of not having a period, and then it started right after that, and now we're 26 days in. Yeah. Not fun. Literally not fun.
Editing Michaela here, just for like, just like a little FYI. That last period that I said lasted like, that was like 27 days in, it lasted 69 days. I had to get the nuts put on, taken out, because I was like, I'm done. Like, literally, birth control's not for me, so it is what it is. Fingers crossed and everything. So the whole goal now is to just work on losing weight and hope that helps regulate my period.
Because one, I hate being on my period. I hate bleeding for long periods of time. Like, and it's not like the pill. It's not like I could just stop. It's in my arm, so they have to cut it out. It's not like I can just stop being on birth control. I have to make an appointment, go in for them to take it out. But also, it's like, it's supposed to help. It's going to help me regulate my period, because we've been in this mode of going months without period. And you need it as a female. And being a female who is, I don't know what the technical term is, but as a female who hasn't gone through menopause, who's still young and still goes through periods, you're supposed to have a period at least every month. It's supposed to help shed your uterine wall. If it's not shedding, all that shit's getting built up. That's not good. So when my doctor talked to me about this, I'm like, okay, I guess we'll try birth control again, help do this, and then also work on losing weight. And the last time I went to the doctor was to get tested, because you know you should always get tested at least every 6 months or every year. So I got tested. Everything came back clean, as I already knew. But also, while I was there, they took my weight. I lost 20 pounds. That's great. Obviously, eating Taco Bell, it's not helping the situation. But, you know, I've been doing really good, eating really healthy, eating mostly home-cooked meals. So this was like a little cheat day for me. And moving around a lot more, and I find myself to be happier, be like a lot more stuff going on. And when I went to the doctor, I was not expecting to see that I lost 20 pounds in a month, which is crazy. I am very happy. That was like 5 pounds a week. So I'm very happy, and I just want to keep moving on that path, because, you know, like one thing that I talked about and that you guys very much know is I want to get the gastric bypass surgery to help me on my weight loss journey even more. So we're going to keep moving and keep going forward. Wish me luck. I've been waking up early. I've been starting to go to sleep earlier. Like, I've been not going to sleep till like 1, 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. Now I go to sleep at like 12 something, 11 something sometimes. Let's try this fire sauce. I'm usually want to get the mild, because the mild be hidden. Is it supposed to like kick in or something? Should have got the Diablo at this point. I just woke up and I guess this is breakfast. It's 11:07, but I didn't want a regular breakfast. I was like, I'm hungry. I saw Taco Bell was open. I haven't had Taco Bell in, I couldn't tell you how long I had Taco Bell. Literally, after I got done washing my face, I saw that my camera battery is gone. Can't plug it in. I looked at my phone. Oh, girl was here. Simba, you just want to be part of the party, huh? I will show you guys soon, but you're on my iPad right now. The reason for this video. I feel like I have so many videos of where I'm like, where I've been. There's been a lot going on. Blah, blah, this, blah, blah, that. Blah, 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 blah. Like, Michaela, how many times are you going to do this? Let's get to it. So, I've been in school. I transferred to a new school. I transferred to Chamberlain University. So, I was going to a school called Northwestern College here in Chicago. 20 minutes away from my house. I found out about this school from a friend. Her sister went there. She went there. Her best friend went there. And her boyfriend went there. You know, nurses, yes. Love that for them. It'll be me soon. Don't worry. Heard about the school. Since they went through it, I assumed it was a good program. And it was. Did my prereqs online. Then last year, I had just started some nursing classes. I started 2 nursing classes. I passed 1 nursing class. The other class I didn't. So I knew that I was going to have to repeat that one. Okay, cool. Just don't let it happen again. But I noticed and realized that I would be done with school if I transferred to a BSN program, because where I was at was just a associate's RN program. If I transferred to a bachelor's of science in nursing program, I could be finished in almost the same amount of time that I would finish at Northwestern. So I was looking at all my options, and I saw Chamberlain, heard
only great things. I transferred to them. I would have been done, if I was still at Northwestern, I would be done in the middle of 2026 with associates in nursing. If I continue on the path that I'm going at Chamberlain, I'll be done at the end of 2026, but with my BSN. If I were to stay at Northwestern and get my associates in nursing, I would be an RN, but there's so much more and so many more opportunities of having a bachelor's in nursing. So I decided to go, instead of having to go back to school to get my bachelor's, I'll just complete the whole program. Little did I know that nursing classes, so from if you're moving from an associate's to a BSN, they won't transfer your nursing classes. If you were in a BSN program and transferring to another BSN program, then they'll transfer your nursing classes. I only took two and I only passed one, so I'm not that choked up about, you know, not getting nursing classes. But because this is a BSN program, I had to do a lot more prereqs because this is a full program. The prereqs that I took at Northwestern, they were transferred over. Great, done. But there's still more prereqs that I have to do. So that's the only downside about it. And it was a little discouraging. I mean, I was discouraged when I found out that I had till 2026 to do at Northwestern. So this is what I thought. I thought the whole program was 2 years, prereqs and nursing classes. No, little did I know, you do your prereqs and then the actual nursing class program is 2 years. So I was like, 2026, let me do the calculator. It's not adding up. Like, when I found that out, I was so discouraged. I just did not want to do school no more. Did not want to do life anymore. I was like, no, this is not what I wanted at all. It's 420 and everybody getting high except for me. Oh, that's like what I'm struggling with. Like, one of the things I'm struggling with right now is just trying to keep my mind stay up, you know, because it can become discouraging. So the program is, you have a new class, like new classes every 8 weeks. It's an 8 week program, where my last school is an 11 week program. Like, last session, I was very, 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 very discouraged. Like, I wasn't happy. I was thinking about not continuing and dropping out. Or I'm not gonna say dropping out, this is not high school. I was thinking about, like, you know, just withdrawing from the program, finding a job, applying to places, because like, I just did not want to do the school shit no more. And like, even times like now, I still feel the same way, just seeing how my grades are going and how they're fluctuating and everything. Like, I'm just not really content with the process of being in school anymore. And then I even question myself, like, do I even really want to be doing this right now? Is this even what I want anymore? I really be like really questioning like my logic on things. Like, do you really want this, Michaela? Sometimes I don't know. The burrito of some kind. I think this is a 5-layer burrito. I just don't be knowing anymore what I want. I don't be knowing. I don't know if y'all saw that TikTok video, but this dude, he'll go to Chipotle and get like a bowl, right? Get a huge ass like tortilla on the side and get like a sauce, and he'll go home and make his own burrito. And I'm just confusion, because he'll do his little thing. Like, it look good. It looks, don't get me wrong. But if I'm going to get fast food, I'm not trying to go home and cook some more. I got the food so I can eat. It's called fast food. I didn't go home to cook some more. Like, listen, you could chef it up in the kitchen all you want, baby. I want the best for you. You want it, you got it. But that's made me for a loop. Like, ain't nobody, like, I was really gonna comment on the video, but I was like, I don't want nobody coming for me and being said, like, well, because you're a fat bitch. Like, no, it's not even that. I could be a big bitch, okay? Thank you. Next. What's next? I was confusion. I'm just like, you go to a fast food place, you go to Chipotle, get this bowl, get this thing going, blah, 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 so you can eat it right when you get home or in the car, wherever you going. But you go home, fill up your tortilla, get the vinaigrette sauce or whatever type of sauce you got, pour it into the sour cream, shake it, shake it, shake it, so you could go home and make your burrito and dip your burrito in your sauce. Why? I'm not going to a fast food restaurant ordering some food just so I could go home and cook some more. I got the fast food so I wouldn't have to cook. But yeah, that video took me out. But it looks. But the extra, it's extra. Okay, I'm not hating the fire sauce. But the mild sauce, I don't know. That mild sauce got some in it. It gives. It's like they put the beans at the bottom. They put all the meat at the top, and now I'm getting beans. Ain't that a shame, Taco Bell? Also, lovies, I've been having guy trouble. Jesus. Gotta put this mouse on. I just gotta go back to the tried and true. It's something about that mild sauce. But I've been having guy issues, and actually this is one of the topics that I wanted to talk about, and I probably will still talk about on the podcast, because I want to go into more depth, not just about me, but about relationships and situationships and FWBs and sneaky links, all that type shit. I want to get into that. That's a topic on its own, and that's one of the episodes where I would love to have the guest that I want, so she could dive into it. As we all know, I am no longer a virgin, not a big secret. But if it is, you know, tell the press, tell the news. Since last year, I've been, like, you know, having sexual relations. But since my birthday, I've been only, you know, having sexual relations with one person.
I just really want to make this clear. When I say, like, last year, I started having sexual relationships, and this year, I've only been having sex with, like, just one person since my birthday. It wasn't that I was having sexual relationships with a whole bunch of people. No. Like, I wasn't doing that. I only have two bodies. Yeah, I only have two bodies. So let's make that very clear. I wasn't just out and about since I lost my virginity. No. I only have two bodies. So let's just make that clear. And since my birthday, I've only been having sex with one of those people out of those two. So yeah.
I really liked, like, this person. He was somebody that I was talking to before. We stopped talking in April of last year, which is kind of funny and crazy because we stopped talking in April of this year. But anyways, this is the only guy I've ever been in love with. I fell in love with him when we first were talking. But he said it first. Let's get that straight. He said it first. So when we were talking before, like, things were going good, and I realized, like, I became too much. Like, I was always texting a lot, this, that, and there, double texting, sometimes triple texting. Anyways, he didn't like that, so it kind of pushed him away. So we stopped talking, unfortunately. But around that time when we were talking, like, we were talking to end up being together. And then we started talking again last year. And then we started hooking up again, talking, blah, blah, this, blah, blah, that. And I was thinking that possibly we could try again, right? Boy, was I wrong. He was like, we're not compatible. I like to be in the house. You like to go out. You make it seem like I'm out here. When I go out to a restaurant, a nice, let's keep it real. I'll go to nice restaurants with my friend, Rebecca, my friend. And it's not every day, every week. Sometimes it's not even every month. Or I'll go out with my family. I never asked anything of him. I never asked him to change himself, but we're not compatible to him. I never asked anything of him. I'm always there when he needs me. I'm always there to talk. I'm like, I've been there in many ways for him. And so I'm just like, if I'm showing you and I'm giving you these reasons to, I'm not like, it's not like I'm pointing them out and writing them out, but there's been so many opportunities and so many reasons for you to want to be with me, but still you don't. And his words were, there's love there. But just because there's love doesn't mean we have to force a relationship. Baby, nobody's trying to force you. But it's like, we do all these things together. We hang out together all the time. We fuck each other. You say you want to put a baby in me, but you don't want to be with me? I'm confusion. Like, it's like really highly not clicking. It's not clicking with me, Steven. I really don't get it. But okay, sir. Okay. And I feel like, is it something else? Like, it has to be something else. Because you don't mind fucking me. You don't mind fucking me. I just don't get it. And it's like, I get to this point where I'm constantly questioning. Like, am I only good enough to fuck and not good enough to be with? Because I have the biggest heart. Like, I really have the biggest heart. I care hard. I fall hard. But people constantly take all that I'm giving for weakness and take advantage of it. Constantly want to use whatever they can, take whatever they can from me, milk me for all that I am, just to end up throwing me in the trash later. It's like I'm not understanding. It seems like for people, and this is the topic that I wanted to get into on the podcast, like, big women, there's a lot of people that love, a lot of men that love bigger women. Who don't fetishize us. Like, let's get that clear. Who don't fetishize us, but actually love big women for being big women. Love big women, or love women for being who they are, no matter what size they are. But I noticed that bigger guys get a lot more love. And I don't know, this is what I've been peeping. Let me cook for a little bit. This is just what I've been peeping. That big guys get a lot more love than bigger women. Like the skinny bitches, the small bitches, slim, thick bitches, big bitches love the big guys. But when it comes to the big girls, I feel like it's not the same. And there's men out there that love us. Don't get me wrong. I see it. I know. Okay? But I feel like a lot of guys rather fuck us, want to have sexual relationships with us, but they don't want to be with us. Or they'll be with us in secret, but not in public. They don't want to post pictures with us, but they'll be cuddled up and booed up with us in the house. Simba, it's not making any sense, is it? No, it's not. It's just, I don't get it. Small girl can have a big guy by her side and love it. I got me a big man. Ooh, I got me something to hold on to and lean up against that night. Love that for me. And everybody loves it. Heart, tap, tap, tap. They love that for them. But when a smaller guy with a big woman, it's, man, like, what are you doing that for? Like, that's not right. To society standards, it should not be. That's blasphemous. Listen, love who you love, okay? Love who you love. I'm all about the love, okay? Love who you love, no matter what color they are, no matter where they're from, no matter what language they speak, no matter what size they are. Love who you love. But back to me, I'm Confucian, because how come I can't get the same respect when it comes to men? Now, the men that I've been with, they're not tiny men. They're not tiny. I've never been with a skinny nigga, but I love them for them. I don't care about what they look like, you know? It is what it is, because I don't want somebody to judge me for what I look like, but I don't want all of this to just be you, me, in the bedroom. Like, if you want me, you gotta want me for me. I want you to hold my hand out in public and don't care what nobody gotta say about it. I'm going on a rant. But I just don't understand why this guy thinks we're not compatible. Like, literally, he tells me, I've done stuff with you that I've never done with any other female. Like, I'm so comfortable with you. I do things with you. Like, I'm extremely comfortable with you. I'm extremely comfortable with him. But it's still not enough. Why aren't these things enough for you to see, like, okay, like, I want to be with you. I want you. Like, why can't nobody love me? Why can't I be the one that gives love? Everybody... Simba. Everybody else is getting love but me. Right, Simmy? He's like, this girl. But it's like, I want to be deserving too. You know? I know that I'm enough. First of all, I'm the damn prize. All right? I'm the damn prize. And the person that chooses me, the person that wants me, for all the glory, luscious beauty, the thick thighs, thick waves, the rolls, everything, for my skin, for my root showing. Oh, trust me, this is getting done soon. Don't talk about me. But for my, like, for everything, but for me, the guy who gets me is going to win a prize. Let me tell you, the prize. Because I am the prize. And you are a prize too. If you're ever thinking about, like, or doubting yourself, like I've been doubting myself for the past month, don't. Because you're a prize. You are the total package. You are worthy. You are deserving. You are loved. I have to keep telling myself this, because I know that I deserve more than what I've been getting. I know that. And I need to learn how to say no. You're not gonna get none of this. If you can't appreciate all of me, you're not gonna get none of me. Period. Poo. So I've been like having my little funks. Like, I've been crying a lot, and this guy just makes me cry. And it's not like he's like screaming at me or yelling at me or telling me stupid shit, but the fact, like, why don't you want me? I'm giving you so many reasons to want to be with me. Yeah. Simba's like, yeah. So many reasons. There's so many reasons you should want to be with me. But still, like, he's not giving. I give everything and I get nothing from him. Zero. So I need to learn how to say no. I need to learn how to back away. I need to learn how to love myself. And once I am healed and I'm loving myself, then the right person will come along without me even just having be totally unexpected. Totally unexpected. So I can't wait for that to happen. I'm putting it in God's hands. God knows what to do. He knows my heart. He knows where to lead me and guide me. So I'm going to put it in God's hands. And that's what y'all should do. Just if you have any worries, just give it to God. He's going to take care of it. I promise you. So much stuff has been going on in these past 2 months. Family stuff, personal stuff, education stuff, health stuff, like so much stuff, not just with me, but just with the people in my life. And I prayed about it. And God literally took my hand. He pushed me aside and he said, baby, I got you, my child, I got you. And he literally took all the things that I prayed about and he did what he do. Because you know God be God, okay? He did what he does. And I tell you, all the things that I was worried about, all the things I was praying about, all the people I were praying for, the situations that were going on, God did what he did. And things are now better. So when it comes to my love life, I'm praying. When it comes to my school, I'm praying. When it comes to my health, I'm praying. And I'm giving it all to God. I said, God, it's in your hands now. It's in your hands now. Because, the past 2 months, everything that's been going on, literally, he's taken it. And he's made everything better. And I'm just like, so thankful and so grateful. And like I said, like when it comes to the end of my videos, we're going up because I'm about to end soon. You guys, you don't need to worry. If you're not religious, like if you're not religious or you don't believe in God, or like just pray or manifest or give your worries up to the universe or to whoever you believe in. Personally, for me, it's God. But give all your worries to whoever you believe in. You will see a difference because, you know, sometimes stop worrying. Put it out there. Ask other people to pray for you. If you're not religious, then you'd be like, I'm not religious, but I know you are. Can you pray about this for me? Can you ask God about this for me? I would gladly do it. I would gladly pray for you. Pray for you. Pray over you. Pray over your situation. Pray over your family, pray over your health issues, whatever you got going on. I will personally pray for you. I prayed for friends. I prayed for the man that I'm telling you guys about. I prayed for myself. I prayed for my family and all the situations that we've been going through. Like, and God has showed us why he's God. God has showed us what he does, because he's definitely paved the way. He's definitely worked miracles these past 2 months, and I'm so grateful for him. But anyways, we have come to the end of the video. Don't forget to love yourself fully, unconditionally, and unapologetically, because that's how I'm gonna love you, and that's how you should love yourself. Don't forget to hashtag keep it holy, because if you ain't got God, then who you got? We haven't done that outro in a while, so I wanted to do that, guys, for you. Do that for you guys. What's going on? Like, literally, I've been saying stuff that But anyways, thank you guys for watching. See you next time. Bye. Mwah.